as I share with us on the subject that I'm calling effectiveness in ministry. And I just want to read a scripture from the book of Galatians chapter 2. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Galatians chapter 2, verse 7 to 9. The Bible says this: "But on the contrary, when they saw that the gospel for the uncircumcised had been committed to me," this is Paul speaking, "as the gospel for the circumcised was to Peter." Other versions would say the gospel to the Gentiles, that is the uncircumcised, that Paul was had it committed to him, and the Jews, that Peter had it committed to him. Verse 8 says, "For he who worked effectively in Peter for the apostleship to the circumcised also worked effectively to me towards the Gentiles. And when James, Cephas, and John, who seemed to be pillars, perceived the grace that had been given to me, they gave me and Barnabas the right hand of fellowship, that we should go to the Gentiles and they to the circumcised." Verse 10, "They desired only that we should remember the poor, the very thing which I also was eager to do." Paul is speaking some very, very heavy words here. He says that when they saw that the gospel that was committed to me, to the circumcised, uncircumcised or rather, as it was to Peter. And I would just like to say that everybody called by God in ministry, there is an area that God has graced you in. It is important to appreciate this for you to be effective in what you are doing. Paul says it was committed to me, to the uncircumcised, just as it was committed to Peter, to the Jews or the circumcised. Don't you realize that this is a very settled man? He's not insecure about Peter, unlike what we see today in church. Brother against brother, sister against sister. One team in church against another team. One ministry against another. And you'll find that we don't appreciate what others are doing. We value what we do much more than what others are doing. Well, Paul says it was committed to me as it was committed to Peter by the same God. And he says that, listen to this, "For he worked effectively in Peter for the apostleship to the circumcised also worked effectively in me towards the Gentiles. I long for a time when a minister that has been raised in the city of Nairobi, in Kenya, in Africa, in the world, somebody with international, connections and impacts, global impacts, will stand and appreciate another minister who is not in their denomination, who is not necessarily in their vision, and stand up before people and say, the God who is working in that brother is the same God that is working in me. Appreciating yourself and appreciating others is a gateway to effectiveness. And Paul says that it was after they recognized that there was grace, there was a commitment that God was working in me, and he was working in Peter in a different way. Appreciate who you are. Trying to be somebody else can only make you number two. You are number one in who you are and who God has made you. Assuming you are Joel, you are the best Joel, right? assume you are Moses. You can't be Moses 2. You are Moses 1. I'm Anthony. I'm the best version of myself. I am equipped to be who I was born and mandated to become. I don't have to be insecure that somebody else is doing well. We should not have this mindset that I am not doing well because somebody else is prospering. Today, your church may have 10,000 members and somebody else's church has 200 members. It's very important that you may realize that sometimes the parameters we use to measure are not necessarily what God looks at. Dorcas was resurrected because of an act of charity. The widows that were beneficiaries of her ministry told Peter that, no, we can't bury this woman. Do you realize that there are bishops that die and nobody, you know, nobody, I mean, there is no trail of impact. But this act of charity, this woman had grace in this area. And appreciating yourself, appreciating who you are, will make you not to feel insecure with the prosperity of others. One may sing, another one may compose a song, another one may be a producer of that song. So when the song is doing well, maybe the BGV has done more work than the person that is appearing on the screens or the producer. Sometimes we fail to appreciate somebody else because we are insecure. We have not discovered ourselves. We have not discovered ourselves. We envy one another. We envy other ministries. We begin projects to counter others, other churches, other ministers, other ministries. What a tragedy, ladies and gentlemen. It is high time that Paul can appreciate what Peter is and what Peter is good at, and celebrate that Peter is graced among the Jews, just like I am. I, Paul, am graced among the Gentiles. So appreciate yourself. You are good. You are in the image of God. You are not God's plan. You are not God's plan B. You are not an afterthought. You are not an afterthought. You are not an idea that just came after something failed. I have a pastor friend. I won't mention his name. Thank you. I won't mention his name. But he says that one day he's the last born in their family. Then one day he overheard his parents talking, and they were saying that they had budgeted for 2 children. And he's the dad born, the last born. So he was not even in the plan of his parents, but he is a pastor today. Yeah. So Paul knew, and then Paul says that when those that looked like pillars, that is Cephas, James, that's verse 9, and John, who seemed to be pillars, perceived the grace. So the grace can be there, but nobody perceives it. Or people who don't have the ability to give you a right hand of fellowship. Destiny help us. People that can facilitate you to your next level. I pray the name of Jesus that the facilities that God has deposited in you, the resources, the capabilities, are going to manifest, and pillars are going to see you. I know somebody is watching me that is at the verge of giving up, but I am here to say that God has sent me to you to tell you that your season is now. Your time is now. You may have been doing a lot and you know what your grace, what God has enabled you to do. But you look like weak people, small people, And this is not meant to, diminish anybody. Everybody is important in the sight of God. But there are people that can facilitate your next level. People that can sponsor your idea. People that can give you an approval that is acceptable. Do you know you can have the recommendation of people that don't have recommendation? There are recommendations that matter. Assuming you are working in a company and as a clerical officer or a secretary, and you want a recommendation for a promotion, would you go to your junior? No. But if the MD, if the person on the highest office recommends you, you are likely to receive certain level of favors. The letter you carry will make sense. Unfortunately, some people end up recommending themselves because they lack men that can see and perceive the grace upon their lives. You may have gone through issues and then you get to a place where you are not visible. So Paul says, when they perceive, so it was until that particular time that they were given the right hand of fellowship. You may be a good man, but you are not known. You may be doing good things, a wonderful business. You may be having, you may be supplying what is in demand, but you have nobody that, you know, those that need your products cannot see you. You may be having the right training, but the people that can hire you are not able to meet you. I pray in the name of Jesus that God will connect you supernaturally. By His divine power, you will meet important people that can lift you. I want to say that it is also important to appreciate others. You appreciate others, and that way you plant a seed and you can also be appreciated. The same measure give to others comes back to you, pressed down, shaken, and running over. So I pray that you become secure with men, become secure with women. Appreciate others. They may not do what you're doing. They may not be good in what you're good at. Moses needed Aaron. Aaron needed Moses. Moses had the word. Aaron had the speech. So both of them complimented one another. They see that ministry is about complimenting one another. It's not about competing with one another. I pray that the Lord will touch your heart, that you don't live a life fighting others, bringing down others. A story is told about some frogs that were being transported from one country to another. Some frogs from Tanzania, some from Uganda, and then from Kenya. So they covered the frogs from Tanzania with in a bucket, of course, and then they put a cover over it. The frogs from Uganda, they also covered. Then they never covered the frogs from Kenya. Kenya is my country, for those watching from other nations. And then the person who was transporting met one of the attendants in the flight, and he asked him, "Why have you not put a lid on the frogs from Kenya?" And he said, "Don't worry about the frogs from Kenya. They can't come out. When one will try to come out, the other one will pull it down." So that's a story trying to tell us that in Kenya we pull one another down. In Africa, we don't celebrate one another. We don't celebrate other ministries. You must know that one person excelling doesn't mean they are replacing you. When there is room for everybody at the top, we need one another. Compliment others, celebrate others, mention others in public, appreciate their services and their ministries, and you know what they can do. They may look weak, but they may even be weaker than you or stronger than you. Whichever, you don't have to entertain jealousy. And many times we may look like, you know, we are celebrating, but don't forget that God judges the hearts. He's able to detect what is in your heart, even when you appreciate me verbally, or when I appreciate you verbally, but deep down in my heart, I am cursing you. God is able to filter, and you know, He gives us justice back. So we must celebrate others. And then I would also like to say that we must understand seasons. The fact that you are not doing well today doesn't mean you'll never do well. The fact that you're in school today doesn't mean you can't be a teacher. Paul says, when? So this is about timing. There are things that can only happen at particular seasons and time. So timing is very important. Don't rush. Don't slow. And I also pray that the devil will not rush you or slow you. There's what we call premature manifestation. You may want to look great, like nowadays people are drunk with titles and names and ordinations here and there. You will find young boys that have nothing to show for ministry, but with so big titles. So you create a great expectation about yourself, yet you have nothing to offer. We have so many apostles, but little apostolic work. Can you imagine one apostle, Paul, causing havoc in an entire generation? Peter, James, John, they have their epistles, they have their apostolic record. But we have so many apostles today, bishops with no churches. In Kenya, we have CS without portfolio. So we are also having bishops without churches, you know. So don't move too fast. And don't slow. Timing is important. Elisha was told by Elijah, when you see me being taken, then the mantle will fall on you. Timing. So the mantle was there. He could have grabbed the mantle and run with it so that he doesn't miss when the man was being carried by the chariot of fire, the prophet Elijah. But he had to wait until that time. Don't you find it strange that Jesus knew he was God, but even when he performed his first miracle at the wedding in Cana, that's John chapter 2, when the mother talked to him, he asked her, "Woman, don't you know that my time is not yet?" Yeah? So, he knew he was God. He knew his capacities and capabilities. But he still allowed the process to go. Until he performed a miracle in Cana, our Savior Lord went through the cross when he had all the power. One time he told Peter that if I would just call my Father, he would release legions of angels and all these people would be scattered. But he went through the cross knowing that all power was within his reach. So how can we be humble enough that at times you know the potential you have, but you can wait until the right time? This will make you effective. We have so many aborted destinies, aborted ministries, miscarried. I love saying that when a woman gives birth at the third month of her pregnancy, we can't call that speed. That's called a miscarriage. When the child comes out too early, it's a miscarriage. But if she gives birth on the first day after her 9 months, that's timing. If she gives birth after 15 months, we'll be concerned if she's still pregnant after 15 months. But I break every spirit of delay and anything that manipulates you to move before your time. I pray that those that are pillars, those that have what you need and need what you have, are going to meet you. Destiny will collide. God has a way of making sure Joseph is in the same season and time with Mary. God has a way of bringing Ruth to the city where Boaz is. God has a way of connecting you to those that need what you have and have what you need. Your certificates will not lie idle. Your capabilities will not go uncelebrated. I declare visibility. May you be visible. May what you say be heard by those that should hear. You know, it's like Joseph. He interpreted dreams for quite a while. His own dreams for the cupbearer and the chief baker. But one day, he interpreted for Pharaoh. And his story changed. He became the prime minister in a foreign land. So I pray that one of these days God will bring you into such a platform where you will not just talk to people that are suffering what you are suffering, people that are going through what you are going through, people that don't have the ability to make you cross. God has a way of making sure that you are in the River Nile, where the daughter of Pharaoh will come to take her shower. God has a way of making sure that the time that Moses is at River Nile, the daughter of Pharaoh comes to shower. And the rest is history. God has a way of bringing you to those that need what you have and have what you need. So I pray for visibility. The Bible says in Isaiah 25 verse 7 and 8 that upon this mountain the Lord shall destroy the curtain and the sheets that covers the nations. I pray that anything that has covered your good and amplified your bad, advertised your bad, advertised your weakness, your inabilities, I pray in Jesus' name that upon this mountain, Mount Zion, the hand of the Lord shall destroy that covering. Anything giving you an identity that is not yours. Any man, any woman advertising your mistakes and barring your strength, may the Lord rise and defend you. I pray for open doors for ministry and strength to overcome the adversaries. Paul said, a great door for effective ministry has been opened for me, but there are many adversaries. You will overcome. I pray in Jesus' name that your history will not, the negativity in your history will not challenge the fruits of your life and your destiny. Paul said, I'm not qualified to be called an apostle because I persecuted the church. I did all this kind of evil. But he says, but by the grace of God, I am what I am. There is what you are, but in Christ there is who you become. May who you become be more audible than who you are without Christ. May who you are be more conspicuous, who God has made you, than who you were. In Jesus' name. Anybody carrying files of your weaknesses to appear and paint your CV black, I pray that the Lord will give you favor. The Lord will give you speed. You will be settled before they arrive. In the mighty name of Jesus. Any negative history, any voice in your background cannot hold your back on the ground. I pray for you that the Lord helping you, you will have the testimony of Paul that when those that seemed pillars saw, they gave us the right hand of fellowship. You're looking for a job. You're being frustrated by some junior, somebody very junior in that company. May the pillar in that company see your CV. You want to get married, some funny people have appeared with funny stories about your yesterday life. Maybe a primary school girlfriend or boyfriend just came and spoiled your wedding. May what God has made you override the rumors. May your performance in nursery school never hinder, and in high school never hinder your success in life. In the name of Jesus, I declare grace over your life. You have been watching this and you are not born again. Just say this prayer after me. You are trusting God for restoration. You feel alone, you feel away from Jesus. I want to lead you in this prayer. Say after me, Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner, forgive me. I acknowledge that Jesus died and resurrected that I may have life. I receive you. Thank you. In Jesus' name. Let me make a prayer for you. Father, in Jesus' name, anybody that has paid attention to this broadcast, I pray in the name of Jesus that whatever needs to break is breaking right now. Every delay in manifestation, every contamination in their ministry, every kind of corruption in their ministry, doctrinal, character, relational, whichever dimension, by your mercy, God, you are stretching your hand towards them to rescue them. Koda la bahana masa. Shelobuko satalama. I declare that, God, you are unveiling that evangelist, that worshiper, that musician that is discouraged, that businessman, businesswoman. You are unveiling them, and significant figures will take cognizance of their presence and abilities. I rebuke every cutting and every covering over their heads, over their products and their certificates. And I declare in the name of Jesus that, Lord, this is their season, that pillars will connect to them. I pray in Jesus' name that there will be change of level, change of dimension for the glory and honor of your name. Thank you for blessing us with a peaceful country. We pray for our leaders. We pray for Kenya. We pray for Africa, that God Almighty, it shall be full of the knowledge of your word as the waters cover the sea. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you.